So our next topic is Noah's Ark. How did your views change on that? And let me just explain the way I see it. Basically, there's three camps in this. There's what they call a young earth creationist camp, which says it was about, I believe it was fourth. They think the earth is about 6,000 years old. About 4,000 years ago, there was a worldwide flood, killed all land animals, except for those saved on an ark, which includes 8 people. Then, you know, some people would say, well, that's crazy. There's no evidence for that whatsoever. When you look at the geologic record, you know, what's out there in geology and the fossil record and all that. So then the next camp is, okay, yeah, we acknowledge that. So really the flood was a local area and all the humans were in a local area and it wiped out all the humans except for those 8 saved them, you know, in that boat. But then still there's a lot of problems with that. So then there's some Christians who go up another notch and say like, okay, well, yeah, the whole thing was a myth. It's not really there to teach history. It's just to teach a theological issue, which, you know, I think it's kind of funny to say, well, what's the theology there, that God gets mad and throws a temper tantrum and causes ecocide? Basically, it's worse than genocide. It's killing all the land creatures. But that's kind of an overview. That's how I saw it. So what's your take on it? How did you come to see it as a Christian and then as an atheist?
Well, what's funny is that I think I've gone through the gamut of all those groups you mentioned. I started as the believing it literally. You know, 4,000 years ago, there was this worldwide flood, and as the Bible said, everything was covered, to the point of now where there's very little doubt in my mind. I just can't come right out and say, just to be respectful to other people, that it's not true. But I know what I believe. I think my big concern is with this story, as with a lot of other stories, is they are clearly copied from something much earlier than they are. In this case, we're talking about like the Noah's Ark story is clearly from the Epic of Gilgamesh, which is in written form is 1,000 years older than when it was supposedly written in the Bible.
Yeah, so I've read the Epic of Gilgamesh. It's actually a pretty interesting read. You can get a small, it's very small, and there. I got one on Amazon.com one time, and the guy wrote a commentary on it. The commentary is also, actually a scholar did this, and it's actually much bigger than I think than the actual story. But the story has, you know, the seek for immortality, and there's sex in it. So, you know, it's like a really interesting product of that time.
Absolutely.
So go on. Sorry to interrupt there.
No. That's exactly what I was thinking. And then when you get into group two, which I apologize, I skipped over. If you're dealing with a local flood, that is a I think you're half right there. I think the author wrote Noah's Ark from a regional point of view, where Noah's Ark might have been large enough for the animals that they were knowledgeable of in that area. But I think because it was written from a local point of view doesn't mean it refers to a true local flood. And what I mean by that is when you read Noah's Ark and you look at it from where we are today and the information that we have to know how big our world is and how many animals are on this in this world, you realize, again, that's just not possible. For one, and there's always three things that I think about when I come to Noah's Ark. One is water, and that when you deal with, if water covered everything, there's not that much water. And of course, then again, you go to, well, it was a miracle.
Right.
Well, it would have to be, because
yeah, there's miracles left and right. Like, how do you feed them? It's a miracle. Where'd the water come from? It's a miracle. What did they eat after they got off the ark if everything was destroyed? It's a miracle. You know, it's like just every question's.
That becomes the answer to everything.
Yeah. Santa Claus. How does Santa Claus deliver all those presents? You know, it's Christmas magic. But he would have to go, you know, microseconds or nanoseconds down every chimney. Well, it's magic, Christmas magic, you know.
Just a miracle, right. Right. But you have in just Noah's Ark story itself, you probably have thousands of miracles when you think about it. You've got the water. You've got the mixture of the salt water and the fresh water.
Yeah.
You've got the fact that you look at this earth today, and if a worldwide flood would have happened, and let's say you take view number one, which is it happened 4,000 to 5,000 years ago, there's not that much. There's we would not have the mountains that we have today because of the erosion caused by that amount of water. It would have been just, I mean, it would have been, the destruction would have been insane just by the weight of the water on this planet. And so often we forget about things like that because it's a good story. We want to believe it as it is. But in light of science, which, you know, part of the question, you deal with that amount of water. I mean, do you see what's just gone on recently in parts of our country here with flooding, like in Texas and some of the other areas? If you imagine that on a worldwide scale where everything was covered, the damage would be beyond what we could ever comprehend.
Well, yeah, plus it says, everything was covered, and it's even for over a year. So, I think one of the funniest rebuttals to that, too, is that I've heard is like, what about other boats? I mean, surely there were fishermen that had boats. And then sometimes the Christians will say, well, maybe it was so turbulent that they couldn't survive it. And then you're thinking, wait a minute, that ark, if it was that turbulent, what would that ark be doing with all those animals? They really get thrown around.
Absolutely. Yes, and you're
So.
dealing with a boat that the amount of water, and I read it somewhere, and I apologize, I don't have the exact quote, but I think somebody had wrote somewhere they thought that the rain would have to fall at the rate of like 6 inches per minute, and that amount of water and that power of the water would have destroyed Noah's Ark. So
Well,
again,
they would say, don't forget
it's a miracle.
it also came up from the ground too. So, there's hidden water. Yeah, it's all a miracle, like you said.
Sure.
One of the funny things about the other boats, what about the other boats? Maybe God went around poking holes in them, it's like that's another.
Anything to make the story work.
Yeah. And I think one of the things about it that's funny about a local flood, if there was just a local area, I think, why would you save birds? Birds could easily fly away to a higher ground. And if it was a local flood, I don't know, it seems like maybe it would be better just to go to high ground instead of getting in a boat and undoing all that.
Right. Yeah.
But
Could have
anyway,
been.
yeah, it's like, why save birds if they could easily fly away? And I don't know how you could have a local flood for over a year that would cover everything either.
Right. Well, clearly the story's written from a point of view of it was a worldwide flood, but again, I think it was written from a regional point of view, somebody who wasn't aware of the world as we are aware of it today, of how big it is and how the different areas and different peoples and different animals. I mean, you have Noah in Genesis 7, he has 7 days, I believe, to gather all the animals. And so in that amount of
Oh,
time, he
yeah.
had to get a koala bear from Australia. He had to get the penguins from Antarctica. I mean, this guy traveled a lot of miles in 7 days to get the animals that were supposedly on that boat.
Well, like you said, I mean, there's another miracle there. So, at one point, you actually believed there was a worldwide flood. You believed all that stuff, and then you kind of backed off of that. And so now, do you see the whole thing just as a myth now?
I see it as a fantastic story. Just like Adam and Eve, it's a good story, and
Not a
I think
historical event, though.
not a historical event, no. There's like a parable. It's a story. We can get some good stuff from it for our lives, but
Yeah.
nothing we should count on as being historically accurate.
So did you come this did you like with this and Adam and Eve, did you come to see it as a non-historical myth before you left the faith, or did you leave the faith first and then discover through more study that it's not true, historically.
No, I believe I saw it as just a story just before I left. I think it was one of the reasons why I began to think, well, wait a minute, if I don't believe these are actually literally true, then I can't continue to believe what I believe, and I certainly can't continue to be the pastor of a church.
Interesting. Yeah.
That wasn't fair to me, or more importantly, to the people who did believe, who I was supposed to be their spiritual leader. That was not, I couldn't allow that to happen.
So, sometimes people say you can't talk people out of religion, or you can't really, I don't know, but it sounds like in your case, I mean, it's your intellect that is leading you out.
Yeah, it was reading, it was research, and the more I read, I thought, wait a minute, this doesn't add up. It just doesn't make sense. And
Yeah.
like we mentioned Gilgamesh earlier, there are so many stories that are older than our biblical text that are almost identical to the biblical text. I started to think, wait a minute, my Bible's not original at all. It's a lot of it's copied from previous stories in other religions, and that really was concerning to me.
Okay. Anything else you want to say on this topic before we move on?
I just think one thing that always that stood out to me as I started to get into science was when you look at the like the microorganism theory of disease. Something I had never thought about was with all those animals on that boat for that amount of time, there's no way everybody stayed healthy.
Well, it was a miracle. You forgot that. That's the answer.
Everything comes back to it had to be a miracle, and
Yeah.
it literally had to be. Yes.
Yeah.